Hi friends, today we are going to understand that the need arised in our research that we want a different sampling rate at the input and the output of a system, of a big huge DSP system. The first question arises that how should I achieve this multiple sampling rates, or what should be my first step? The first basic step, or we can say that this could be achieved in two basic methods. Okay, I will not bifurcate the methods, but directly jump into the method. The first method, according to the literature, says that I will use A to D converters. Okay, so we will use A to D converters for achieving different rate at the input and output. Second, we will be not using A to D converters, but it will be a totally digital domain conversion. Okay, so we will be having an A to D converter domain and digital domain. What do you mean by A to D domain and what do you mean by digital domain? For example, let us see the first mechanism. What I'll do is, I'll get the input, which is X of N, right, which is sampled, let's say, at fx. Sampling frequency is fx, which is equal to 1 upon tx. I'll pass this signal through a D to A converter. So I got digital input, which is sampled at a rate of fx. Now I am constructing an analog signal. So let's say if I had a digital signal, something like this, now that passes through a D to A converter and produces an envelope of analog signal, let's say something like that. Okay, what I do is, now this is a continuous signal. Okay, it will be a more distorted one, but let us see what happens. So I have converted to analog, I got an analog signal, then I sample it again. So what I'm doing, I'm again using a sampler. This sampler now will be working at a different sampling rate. So now the new output, that is Y of N, will be a digital signal, because sampling will produce a discrete signal, because sampling will provide a discrete output, which will be at a rate of F Y, which is equal to 1 upon P Y. And F Y is not equal to fx. Okay, so what I did, I have applied a to d or d to a converters, you can say. I have used x of n, which is discrete, convert it into analog, resample the analog signal at a different rate, and produce the different sampled version. What would be the problem? The major problem arises at d to a conversion. When I do D to A conversion, there will be huge amount of approximation used over here, and that approximation will actually make my analog signal to suffer. Furthermore, I am again using sampling at different rate, which will further remove or approximate lot of information. So in this type of conversion, we will be losing huge number of data. But then what will be the advantage? The advantage of doing this method is that my f of x and f of y can be any arbitrary value. Does it really matters that what should be fi? Should be an integer multiple of fx, or should be in any relation with fx? No, does not matters. What matters is, I will first convert to analog signal. For the sampler, he does not know that this analog signal is coming from some discrete value. For this sampler, this is an analog signal as an input, and I can sample this analog signal at required sampling rate. So fy and fx could be any arbitrary values. So there could not be any relation between fy and fx. Such type of sampling is possible using a D to A conversion, but on a loss of data, because there will be huge loss of data at both the stages, and it is in cascade. So the loss will be multiplied. Okay. Let us see the second method, which is a 100% digital domain method. In digital domain method, I'm not going to get any analog signal in between. That means it will be a 100% digital oriented signal. In this method, what we do is, I will design a digital system which will take the input as fx, which is nothing but 1 upon tx, and produce the output at a sampling rate of fy, which is 1 upon ty. Okay, and there will be some sort of relation between fx and fy. Okay, we can see like this. Fx is, let's say, fx is fy by 2, or I can say fy is equal to twice that of fx. Okay, that means I'm doubling the sampling rate. Or I can also write it as fy equals to fx by 2. I'm halving the actual sampling rate. So in this method, in the pure digital domain method, fx and fy will be related to each other. There will be some sort of relation. As you can see over here, I'm using an integer values. We will shortly come to a point that it is not mandatory that you should always use an integer value. We can do other sorts of non-integer values also. That's not a problem. Okay. So we will be developing a system which will be 100% discrete time, we will be working in discrete time domain only, and we will be designing or giving a new data rate or a new sampling rate, but that sampling rate will be related or in relation to the input sampling rate. So in digital domain, there will be some relation of input and output sampling rate. In analog domain, or when we are saying that conversion from discrete to analog signal, there should not be any relation between fx and fy. Fx and fy can be chosen arbitrarily. We don't have to actually have any sort of relation. That doesn't mean that there cannot be any relation. You can build relation in there also, but they are independent. You can put fy as equal to twice of fx also. That's not an issue over there also. You can do that, but you can choose any arbitrary. I can put 1.5 times of fx. That doesn't really matter. But here, to put that 1.5 times of fx, we have to do something more extra in digital domain. So in this way, we can implement a multi-rate signal processing using two methods. One is using D2A converters. Second, using digital domain. In digital domain, the rates fx and fy will be in relation, whereas in D2A converter, fx and fy need not have any relation. They are arbitrarily selected. A to D converter or D2A converter suffers due to loss of information, but in digital domain, that does not happen. So that is one of the advantage of a digital domain multi-rate sampling. So that is all about, and that is this basic two methods that is there in the literature. We will be more focusing on the second method because we are dealing with discrete time signals. So I'll be more focused on digital domain multi-rate signal processing. Thank you.